proudly brought to you by Hovatek. Hovatek, just a button away.
In this video tutorial, I'll be explaining how to back up a Mediatek Android phone's firmware using WWR MTK 2 and SP Flash 2. Now, I already have a guide on how to dump using SP Flash 2, but the advantage of this method is that you don't need to have gotten a scatter file for your exact phone model, okay, unlike in the SP Flash 2 method, and also that it processes the raw dump into separate files like boot, recovery, preloader, and the rest for you, okay. And you also need to have installed your VCOM drivers, very important, and also we have a guide on that, so check it out. And you also need to have noted or taken note of your phone's chipset. We also have a guide on how to know your phone's chipset. Now, once you've done this, what you want to do is to open the WWR folder where you're going to be launching the WWR MTK exe file, and then you wait for the dashboard to come up. Alright, once it comes up, you notice that it's in Russian, so you have to change the language. What you do is click on the tab here, click on language, and then you click on English, and then you close the tool right here, and then you are going to relaunch it. So when you relaunch it this time around, it's going to be in English, then we can proceed. Alright, great. So let me try to resize this ahead of the other stuff I'm going to be doing, so it's just going to be much easier for me to navigate between these. I think I can resize and smaller. Okay, so now what you want to do is select your, okay, let me just drop it back here. I don't think I can go smaller than this. Now, what you want to do to select your phone's chipset, we have a guide on how to know your phone's chipset, so check it out. My phone's chipset is somewhere down here. Somewhere, all right, I've spotted it. This is my phone chipset. Then your memory type, EMMC or NAND. Usually it's going to be EMMC, but you can do some research on your phone specs to know what it is, but usually it will be EMMC. Then you click on create and save as, and this is going to create a temporary scatter file. Navigate to location where you want to save your scatter file. I'll choose my WR folder and click on save. So that is going to create a temporary scatter file. We can navigate to the location of the scatter file, and then I'll open using Notepad plus plus, so you can see what it looks like. It's just a temporary scatter file, it's not a full scatter file like you are probably used to. Okay, the goal is just to extract certain values from this scatter file. All right so we have this scatter file here, and we are going to be using some values from scatter file. Okay, so just minimize, let's just minimize that. Now, what we want to do is to launch SP Flash 2. We are going to put in a readback of preloader.bin. Okay, what we want to do right now is to back up or read back preloader.bin using the values from the scatter file. Just click on OK. This is not a serious, nothing to worry about. So you click on choose. You are going to be loading the scatter file which WWR just created. Navigate to the location where the scatter file is, Hovatek WWR process SP dump scatter file. Yeah, so say scatter file, and then you click on open. That's going to load just one entry in SP Flash 2. So you go to the readback folder. We are going to be reading back the preloader, but it's going to be in two steps. First, we read back ROM underscore zero, then we process ROM underscore zero. Okay, so you click on add. That is going to click on add. That is going to add this row. Then you double click this row here, window will pop up. Now in this window that pops on, navigate to where you want to save the rom_0 file, then you leave it named as rom_0, don't change the file name, you click on save. Now in this window that pops up, well, let me resize, under region you select EMMC_boot_1, then under start address just 0x0 should be fine. That is the default start address. Now under length, you go to your scatter file, under partition size you copy the value you have there and then you paste it under length, okay, and you click on OK. So you are going to read back the raw preloader.bin as rom_0, then click on read back. Now power of the phone still with battery, don't hold any button, then you connect it to the PC via USB cord. SP Flash to detect the phone if you have your VCOM drivers installed, and then you should have the bars loading any minute now. All right, great. So we have a red loading bar and then it should be complete. All right, green, okay, so you can close this. Now what you want to do is navigate to the location where you save the rom_0 file. This is the raw preloader file. We still have to process it to preloader.bin. Okay, I have my rom_0 here. Okay, I still have to process this file. Okay, using WWR to get my raw preloader.bin. Now go to WWR. Okay, you can minimize this part. Okay, now in WWR you click on select file at the top right corner. Now a window will pop up after you click it. Now in this window, select the rom_0 file. We're going to process in this to get us preloader.bin, and you click on open. Now once the tool has loaded it, you go to the preloader tab. Let me reposition. So you want to go to the preloader tab, then you click on preloader analysis. That's the button by the top left. You click on preloader analysis, that's going to analyze the preloader. Sorry, now once you have these details displayed, what you want to do is to go to click on to extract preloader and save as. That's this button at the bottom. So just rename this file to preloader. It already has an extension as .bin at the bottom, so I just name it preloader. It will have an extension .bin based on save as type. Then you click on save. So that's going to save a file called preloader.bin. Okay, I can click on OK to the same folder we have my rom0. So yeah, I have my preloader.bin. So what I've just done is to process my raw rom0 to preloader.bin. So now I can go ahead with the next step. Now the next step is to do a RAM test using this preloader.bin in SP Flash 2. The goal of the RAM test is to get the start address and length for my full ROM dump. But before you do that, you need to go to download. I need to reload the scatter file so that it can detect the preloader, because preloader is required for the RAM test. So I'll click on choose again, select scatter file, and then this is going to be ticked automatically. Okay, I just rush through that. Now that memory test, you untick everything, but you leave RAM test ticked, and then you click on start. Don't forget to delete your scatter file so that preloader will be ticked under download. Now once you've clicked on start, what you want to do is to power off the phone still with battery in, you connect it to the PC via USB cord, and snap. Okay, I think I have to repeat the process. Let me just quickly do that. I think I'll pause here, quickly reload the scatter file and run through that again. So reconnect and wait for a detection. All right, great, I can close this. So this is the info I really need for my memory test. Let me drag this. So scroll to the bottom right here. Now under EMMC underscore part underscore user, you need to copy the value of size. That's the last thing you have there. Just copy that just before the bracket. Okay, you copy the values you have there, and then maybe just open Notepad and you save the value there. We're going to be using this value as our length for the full ROM dump. Okay, we're back, we're going to dump the entire ROM. All right, so now we'll go back to SP Flash 2, go to the Readback tab. Yeah, but I don't have memory test. You go to the Readback tab, you can remove that entry, click on add again. I removed the first entry, so you double click. You are going to be going through the process all over again, but using different values. So this you can name ROM underscore 2. This is going to be our ROM 2, ROM underscore 2. I just skipped one because I already did that. I don't need that particular one, so I can name ROM underscore 2. Now you copy, now look at this value. You know you have zeros, several zeros before the first non-zero, which is 3. So I just cut off all the zeros before the first non-zero digit. Okay, the first non-zero digit here is 3. Okay, so I cut off all the zeros between X and that 3. So I copy the rest I have there. For start, I put 0x0. For length, I just copy what I have from the Notepad and I click on OK. Don't forget, all zeros between X and the first non-zero digit go. So I can click read back here. Read back. Okay, so what you want to do now is to power off the phone. We are doing a full read back. You still be battery inside, you connect it to the PC, no buttons held. Now this is a full dump. We are backing up the phone's entire partitions, so this is going to take a while. Okay, so it's something you have to just have to do, and once this starts backing up, you have to, excuse me, you have to take a walk or read a book, I don't know, just do something, get busy. This is going to take a while. Okay, but don't interrupt the process, because if you do, the phone will go dead and you have to keep charging to get it to come back up. So I'm going to, okay, I have 1%. I'm going to just pause till this gets to like 99%, then I can pick up. All right, great. So 99% and we are almost done. I'll just wait a while for us to hit the 100% and then we'll be done. So now once this is done, what we are going to have is the ROM underscore 2 file, which is a raw dump of which is a full raw dump. Okay, a raw full dump, let me put it that way. So you close it, so we have a full dump which is in its raw state, ROM underscore 2. So now we need to process this raw dump, okay, to get the component file, the recovery, preloader and the rest. Now to do this, we go back to our WWR tool. Now go to the auto mode. Now under select file, you click on this select file. Let me just deselect my chipset. I don't know why this keeps changing. So you click on select file. Now this menu that pops up, you select the ROM underscore 2, which is supposed to be raw dump. That's the complete dump. Now this shows all the partitions which are contained in the dump I just made. Now this pop-up says you have to select your preloader.bin, so you click on OK. Now select preloader.bin and then you click on open. So this is backing up already. This is going to take a while, so you have to. Okay, no, it's not backing up yet. I still have to select these partitions. Okay, so under scatter tab, you can select the partitions you want to back up. I've not given the go ahead. Sorry. So you can select the partitions you want to back up. Let me slide this way. So you have a list of all the partitions. Let's say I want to allow NVRAM. I want to add NVRAM to the list. Okay, you will see that NVRAM is false here. Okay, so to change it to true, I will double click it. So when you change it from false to true, that means it's going to be contained in the processed backup. Okay, not everything is true, of course. So those that are marked as true will be contained in the final process, in final ROM. Okay, so back to the auto mode. I'm going to give you go ahead by clicking the button at the bottom. It is to build the firmware. Okay, in this window, just select the folder where you want to save the process files and then click on select folder. I advise you create a new folder, okay, and then select that folder and sit back while the two processes the raw file into component file. So this is going to take a while, so just be patient, don't interrupt the process. Okay, partitions already being processed. I think I'll just pause here and get back to you once it's almost done. Alright, great. So we have a done message, done in red. So I can now go to the folder which I selected, and here I have all the component files. Okay, so I should have created a new folder, selected that. You will have it dumped in the same location where I have my ROM 0 and the rest. So you can clean up maybe by deleting some files you don't need. Like my ROM underscore 0 and 2, I don't need them anymore, so I can just delete them. As I said, I should have created a new folder to, you know, process this, and you can just delete any of the files you don't need. I have to scatter files there. You can just delete whichever one doesn't match your. You can retain the complete one and delete the incomplete or temporary one. So that's basically how to dump a Mediatek Android phone's firmware using WWR MTK2 and SP Flash tool, of course.